In this video, we are going to show you how to take a full name field in Airtable and split it out into a first name and a last name. I was recently creating a document automation where I needed the first name in a letter, but I was only given the full name. So I quickly split out the first name. I sent all that data to my document that was automated. I created hundreds of letters in no time at all. They were all customized for the recipient. If you want to learn more about that, head over to notecodecollab.com. Check out our university course on document automation. So now let's dig in and see how we can make this happen. Okay, so we are inside of Airtable. We've got a list of names. Let's add a column for first name. And we're gonna make that a formula. Now what we wanna actually do is we wanna grab from the beginning of the string for the first name. So we wanna grab from the left side of the string. So we are going to use the left function. And if you look on the little pop-up that shows up here, we need to give it a string and then a number of characters. So let's just start with name, because that's what we're pulling from. Name comes up. And then you'll see it's looking for a number. So we're giving it a string and then it's looking for a number. Now, our number is variable. We are looking for the position of the space in between the names. So you can see here with Chloe, it's 5 characters, but then Amelia is actually 6 characters. So we need a variable number. If I just throw in any number, let's take a look at this. So if I give it 7, you can see that Ava, we're starting to get into her last name, whereas Jackson, we got the full first name. So we need to be dynamic. So what we're gonna do is we are going to, instead of saying 7, let's just go like this and come on to a new line. Instead of saying 7, we're trying to find a dynamic number. And the way that we get a dynamic number is by using the find function. So we're going to find something in a string. And what we're going to find is the space. So we are going to put quotes around a space, and then we are going to look for that space in the string name. So now let me just bring this back up to that first line. That becomes our number because the find function is going to return a number. So if we save that, we've got our first name. Easy peasy. Now the last name's a little different, but similar. So we're gonna create a field called last name, and it's gonna be a formula. And we actually wanna come from the right side instead of the left side. Or you could come from the left side and then start at the space and go to the end. But let's just show you how to do it from the right side. So we're gonna actually grab from the right, and similar to the left, we are giving it a string, which is the name field. And then we wanna tell it how many characters from the right do you wanna grab. So in, again, this is variable, but Worthington, we're gonna need to grab a lot more characters than Everly. So what we need to think about is, let's pretend that Amelia Worthington has 25 characters in her name, and the space comes at position 7. Well, we want to grab then 18 characters. 25 minus 7 means we are grabbing 18 characters. I think my math is right. So what we actually want to do is we want to take the total length of this and subtract the position of the space. So we're going to grab the length of the name, and then we are going to subtract the position of the space. So we're going to use that find again, and we're going to find that space in the name. And so now we should be able to create that field, and now we have all our last names. So that is fantastic. This is working, and it is working until you have a leading space in your name. So let's just pretend for a second that the data that we get is not clean. So we have a space at the beginning, maybe we have a space at the end, couple spaces at the end. So our data isn't clean. So once I open that up, you'll see that Ava's, that doesn't work anymore. Our find function is looking for that space, and there's a space right away. So we need to trim off that space. Now, what you could do is you could create another column, and you could trim the leading and lagging and spaces from the name, and then you could reference that new column from your first and your last names. But let's just actually bake everything in. So what we're going to do is anytime we see the name column, the name value, we're just going to add trim. And so we are going to trim that name every time we see it. So let's save that. And so now you can see that Ava, even though it has a space at the beginning, we've trimmed that stuff off. So now we come back here to let's edit the field. And let's just do it on these as well, just to make sure that we are not setting ourselves up for failure. So we can go trim. Anytime we see name, and we should be good to go here. Boom. So now we've got a situation where regardless of what's in here, if you've got leading or lagging spaces or trailing spaces, you can we can still grab the first and last name by trimming those spaces off. Hopefully this tip helps you. Once you're able to split apart first and last name, now you can do a lot more things with that data. For example, I use first name quite a bit in a lot of document automations, as I mentioned earlier, where we are taking the first name, we're putting it in a letter, maybe we're putting first and last name on different rows for a receipt or an invoice or some sort of a certificate or something. But if you want to learn how to automate your documents and take this data from Airtable and feed it into a document template and put your documents on autopilot, head over to nocodecollab.com. We've got a whole university course on document automation so you can start to take your documents to the next level. So thanks for watching, and we will see you at the next tutorial.